What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is TDS Darth Wage back at you with another video. And before I begin this video, I want to give a shout out to a Star Wars fan slash friend of mine. His channel is called Star Wars Cantina Talk. He's trying to get it out there, so I would like anyone who watches me to give his channel a chance. Check out his content. You'll probably like it. He talks about Kathleen Kennedy, Ron Howard, what he wants to see in the next Star Wars movie, Boba Fett, and many other topics yet to come. So as I said, check him out, and if you like his videos, then please smash that thumbs up and give him a sub. I'll leave the link to his channel in the description of this video. By the way, I almost forgot, he wanted me to tell you he is doing a giveaway, so if that interests you, then you have one more reason to check out his channel. So, Cantina Talk made an interesting video topic about why Kathleen Kennedy needs to go, and I would just like to take the time to give you my own personal thoughts on why I also think Kathleen Kennedy needs to go. So I'm going to give you my list of why I think she needs to go. So, let's do this. Number one, Kathleen Kennedy has made comments and shirts saying that the Force is female. So, what got to me about this is, she's acting like Star Wars has never had a strong female character in the history of Star Wars. So, I wonder just how many badass female Star Wars characters there has been. I wonder. Well, for one, now we have Rey Sue, the daughter of Mary and Gary Sue. We have Leia Organa, Ahsoka Tano, Hera Syndulla, Maz Kanata, Mon Mothma, Mara Jade, Jaina Solo, Aayla Secura, Cor Sela, Captain Phasma, Mission Veo, Anya Solo, Jan Orr, Shaak Ti, Nomi Sunrider, Thierry Vila, Sabine Wren, Aura Sing, Asajj Ventress, Brianna the Handmaiden, Darth Treya slash Kreia, Darth Xana, Lamia, Lamaya, whatever. And trust me, people, this is just a small list of female Star Wars characters. And I know you are probably going to say, but wait, some of these are Legends and EU characters and are no longer canon, right? Well, tell me this, you oh-so-smart fans who defend Disney and Kathleen Kennedy and Rian Johnson and J.J. Abrams to no end. Was it our fault that Disney made so many strong female characters non-canon? So the real question is, if we're called sexist for just simply speaking about a female character and giving our reason for not liking that character for obvious reasons, wouldn't that make your precious Disney sexist for erasing so many strong female characters from the canon of Star Wars? That's not the only reason I got mad when she said that the Force is female. By now, anyone who watches and has watched Star Wars knows that the Force is in all living things, not just men and not just women, but all living things. That's why one aspect of the Force is called the Living Force, and another is called the Unifying Force. There is no female side of the Force, and there is no male side of the Force, and the third aspect is irrelevant to the topic. Number two. Kathleen Kennedy said she does not need to cater to the male fans of Star Wars. She sure likes to get under our skin, does she not? For one, you don't have to cater to any specific gender. Just don't show favorites to either side. Make them both badass in their own way. Don't make the men look like stumbling idiots who need some kind of fucking motherly guidance while making all the women look superior mentally and physically. Number three. She talks and acts like we have never had any strong female lead roles in the history of any franchise. Well, just for the sake of this video, I will once again go into a small list of movies that will prove otherwise. Terminator, Alien, Aliens, Resident Evil, Wonder Woman, Aeon Flux, Black Widow, Kill Bill, Kick-Ass, The Hunger Games, Tomb Raider, The Fifth Element, Ghost in the Shell, Underworld, X-Men, The Matrix, Ultraviolet, Logan, and Would You Like to Know More? Because that list does not end anytime soon. Number four. She said, I don't analyze things all the time, I just do them. Okay, so I have to ask the question. What are you, the bitch version of Heath Ledger's Joker? You trying to quote the Dark Knight Joker to sound cool or some shit? Because I remember exactly what Joker said in that movie. He said, "Do I really look like a guy with a plan? You know what I am? I'm a dog chasing cars. Well, I wouldn't know what to do with one if I caught it, you know? I just do things." Get your wannabe female version of Joker's ass out of this franchise, and since you like Joker quotes so much, I have one just for you that should sound very familiar right about now to every Star Wars fan in the world. Upset the established order and everything becomes chaos. And that's exactly what you and Rian Johnson have done with what we already had established. And now everything is chaos. People don't even know who or what the fuck is canon anymore because you motherfuckers seem to be cherry-picking what's canon at this point. Number 5. She said when she joined Lucasfilm, she immediately saw the true passion shared by Star Wars fans. Bitch, I bet you did, because I hate your fucking ass with a passion. Number 6. She said she don't do remakes. Bitch, you literally remade Spaceballs with The Last Jedi and tried to call it canon to Star Wars. Shut your extra sexist ass up. No one wants to hear your lies. Ever since her and Rian Johnson got involved with Star Wars, it's been nothing but constant drama. And Rian Johnson, trust me, your ass is next. And oh boy, do I have such a lovely video to make about you, buddy. Well, that's going to be all for this video. If you like the video, then please like, comment, subscribe, and share, and I will catch you in my next video.